ladies, how y'all doing? You are fine, thank you. My name is Obi. I'm a comedian and I'm a doctor too. Yeah, thank you very much. So I'm going to do my version of the SMPs, you know. It's good to be here. I miss people who read other books apart from Facebook. I'm so glad to be part of you guys. I didn't know how to dress, you know. I didn't know, so I just picked some stuff and then I walk. But I know you ladies, you dress. A round of applause for all ladies here. Yeah. And real quick, how many of you ladies here wear waist trainers? Waist trainers, you know, La Paz girls call it bulletproof vest. But I'm not here for La Paz girls, I'm here for you. So how many of you wear waist trainers? Waist trainers, please show my hand. Why do you wear it? Why? Earlier you hug a lady and you feel all the muscleness that comes with womanhood. Flesh to bone. But now it's changed. You hug a lady, it's like you are hugging your laptop back. I don't understand. And you know, earlier you would play with the lady, you would sneak up on her and take her, you can't do that anymore, you break your index finger. What is it? I mean, I don't get it. And some of you, the makeup man, now we can't sneak up on you and play tricks on you. You live and our hand is full of paint. Oh, it's fraud. I think we can see all the ladies who wear waist trainers, you know. But I love Ghana and I love my job as a doctor too. The job as a doctor is lucrative and popular earlier. But now, it's just lucrative, it's not popular anymore. You see, earlier you see a parent with a kid, throws the kid up. Kwejo doctor, hey, doctor. The parents were doing that. Even when the kid is as dumb as anything, you know. Kwejo 1+1=7, Kwejo 5, hey, what one, yeah, but still, doctor. Parents were doing that, but now it's changed. Yesterday, I closed from work, I met one parent with a kid. Kwejo, somewhere down there, wow. Don't let me hear you say, Kwejo Razak, grandma, man. It's amazing, you know, but most of us have motivations. You know, motivations, I was motivated by my mom to be a doctor, of course, not the comedy part. The comedy part is my dad, not. My mom motivated me to be a doctor. How many of you have parents in the house who are doctors in the house? They never went to the medical school, but they would attend to you. Yeah, Ghanaian parents, a round of applause for them, our moms. Look, unlike a white setting, the white people go to them, mommy, I have a headache. The mom be like, oh my God, my baby has a headache, oh my God, it could be Ebola, it could be SARS. She goes to Google, pa, signs of headache, pa, oh my God, it's asthma, oh my God. And then she picks phone calls, 911, ambulance comes to pick the kid to the hospital. Headache. Come to my house, I have a headache, I go to my mama, me tia me a hunger, I put you ya. And I want it. Only it. And I now, connect. Now I'm at the time, I'm at the time. And amazingly, I go and name and come and I'm fine. Around the couple of African moms, man, wonderful people. I love my job, especially when I meet old patients, you are, man, if any of you here, 50 years and above, you are wonderful, man. Especially those of you who work at the district assemblies. Hey, you people can lie. You can ask them, how old are you? I say, doctor, how old are you? They say, how old are you? Tell me. Because they know they lie about their age. When you ask them their age, they want to lie more. You know, some of them give it to you like you've asked them for lotto numbers. Mr. Ayin, how old are you? So, from 40, 45, 50, 55, 60. Strike the average. I'm like, wow. And some of them give it to you like it's a journey they are going through. Mr. Ayin, how old are you? Oh, it's a CRD. Meaning I'm 45. Maybe 50. And Chenegu 60. And then a jogging. Some of them give you options to choose from. That's what one thing I don't understand. Options. Like, Mr. Ayin, how old are you? Dr. Apedi, I mean. And Apedi saying, oh, say your real age. And you're buying it. Oh, real age, 66. I'm buying 44. Wow. I always introduce myself to ladies like, hey, my name is Obi. I'm an eye doctor. But I don't know Ghanaian ladies.
Anytime you tell them you're a doctor, that is when they forget about the date you guys have gone and they break their medical history. Like, oh, you're a doctor. Oh, my eye. See, it has been itching. And they bring my mommy to her eyes. So, like, really, it's a date, man. So I've changed. You ask me, what do you do? I say, oh, my name is Obi. I'm a gynecologist. Any problem? You don't have any problem? No problem? Okay, let's go on. I love Ghana because of our tribal understanding. Oh, for a better way, you can give me a better way. Tribal, it's your man's name. Prophet. Yeah, fufu. You know? Tolerance. God bless you.
Tolerance.
You know, so I was wondering if Jesus was born Ghanaian. Jesus was born Ghanaian. Which tribe would he be? Oh yeah, yes, give me a Ewe.
What about you? Jesus will not be Ewe.
About you. No, about you. No, look, an Ewe man will not be that weak and humble for you to kill him like that. No. You put the nail in April Jesus' hand. You feel it in your ribs. Put the nail, back at this. But why are they put the nail for your hand and they put for effort? You've not asked for my permission. Which other tribe? Ashanti. Forget. Jesus will not be Ashanti. Ashanti person, before you kill him, man, he has to grab to you. Yeah, I'm going to come.
How long people they don't talk much? You go. Yeah, they fast. Come in fast, Nana. You said 3 days later, make sure you are lying. Come to me, Madina, what lie, Mary Benji, what lie. Yeah, they fast. Come in, Nana. Come in. Come in.
I believe, you know, imagine how that Jesus, like on the cross, and then the guy, Jesus, free yourself. But I believe Jesus can only be a fanty. Round of applause for fanties. No, fanties, you rock. It's only a fanty man who will be meek and humble for you to slaughter and kill him. Ah, Rukun. Hey, and beg for forgiveness. Ah, boss, fetch your wine. Ah, madai. Thank you very much. My name is Obi. Spread the gospel, man. I'm standing. God bless you.